Welcome to iCare Central. In this video, we will learn the difference between primary deviation and secondary deviation as seen in cases of squint. So suppose this is our patient and he has left-sided sixth nerve palsy. The extraocular muscle that is supplied by sixth nerve is the lateral rectus muscle. Therefore, in sixth nerve palsy, the lateral rectus muscle is affected. It is underacting. The function of lateral rectus muscle is abduction, which means that it pulls the eye temporally. So if this patient has a left-sided sixth nerve palsy, it means that his left lateral rectus muscle is underacting. Now, which muscle is the antagonist of lateral rectus muscle? The antagonist of a muscle is another muscle in the same eye that acts in the opposite direction. Therefore, the antagonist of left lateral rectus would be left medial rectus. Lateral rectus pulls the eye temporally, while medial rectus pulls it nasally. So in sixth nerve palsy, when the lateral rectus muscle is underacting, there is no opposition to the action of its antagonist, that is the medial rectus, and the eye is pulled inwards. So the patient presents with a left eye esotropia, or we can say a left eye convergent squint. So in this patient, the right eye is the normal eye and the left eye is the affected eye. Suppose we ask this patient to fixate on the torchlight and he fixates with his right eye, which is the normal eye. We see that the light reflex is falling on the temporal border of the left eye's pupil and it is central in the right eye. So, the Hirschberg test in this case is 15 degrees of esotropia in the left eye. If you wish to learn how to perform Hirschberg test properly, I have already posted a video on this topic. You will find the link in the description box below. So our patient has a 15 degrees of esotropia in the left eye. Now when we put a prism in front of the left eye and measure the amount of squint, say we get a deviation of 35 prism diopters. So this deviation in the affected eye, that is the peritic eye, when the patient is fixating with his normal eye is known as primary deviation. So in primary deviation, it is the normal eye that is fixating and we are measuring the deviation in the palsied eye, that is the affected eye. Before we discuss secondary deviation, we must understand the concept of yoke muscles. Yoke means to move together. Yoke is this wooden thing that is attached to the necks of two animals so that they are in a way connected. And when one animal moves, the other animal moves as well, and they pull the cart together working like a pair. The same way, the muscles of one eye are yoked with the muscles of the opposite eye. They move together. Suppose I place this pen to the right side of the right eye, the patient moves his right eye to look at this pen. Now, even though this pen is not in the field of vision of the left eye, we see that with the movement of the right eye, the left eye moves as well, and they move by the same degree, by the same amount. This is because the muscle moving the right eye to the right side, that is the right eye lateral rectus muscle, its yoke muscle is left eye medial rectus muscle. So when the right lateral rectus contracts, the left medial rectus also contracts, taking both the eyes to the right side. This conjugate movement of the eyes can be explained by Herring's law of equal innervation. Herring's law of equal innervation states that during conjugate eye movements, equal and simultaneous innervation goes to the yoke muscle of the opposite eye. Means it receives the same amount of stimulation and at the same time. So when the brain sends stimulus to the right lateral rectus to contract, its yoke muscle, that is the left medial rectus, also receives the same amount of stimulation at the same time, and thus it will move the left eye nasally by the same amount, like this. Yoke muscles are also known as agonists or synergists, and this is true for all directions of gaze. Both eyes move simultaneously because of equal and simultaneous innervation received by the two yoke muscles. So now that this concept is clear, let's go back to our original example of left-sided sixth nerve palsy. We have already talked about primary deviation, which is the deviation in the palsied eye when the patient fixates with the normal eye. Now suppose I cover this patient's right eye, which was the normal eye, and ask him to fixate with the left eye, which is the affected eye. Now we know that his left lateral rectus muscle is underacting. So to bring this eye to the midline to be able to fixate, the left lateral rectus muscle will need extra innervation to make that extra effort because it is weak. So the brain will send excessive innervation to the left eye lateral rectus muscle, and by Herring's law of equal innervation, the same amount of excessive innervation would go to the right eye medial rectus, which is its yoke muscle. Left eye lateral rectus muscle is underacting, but the right eye medial rectus muscle is normal. Both are receiving excess innervation, therefore right medial rectus would contract by a greater amount than left lateral rectus muscle, and thus the right eye would move more than the left eye, and this patient will have a right eye esotropia. Now let's remove the cover and do Hirschberg test. We can see that the light reflex is falling between the temporal margin of the pupil and the limbus in the right eye, and it is central in the left eye. So now our patient has 30 degrees of esotropia in the right eye, and by prism test, the amount of deviation comes out to be 60 prism diopters. So this deviation in the normal eye, when the patient is fixating with the palsied eye, is known as secondary deviation. We can clearly see here that the secondary deviation is more than the primary deviation, and this is a characteristic feature of paralytic squint. So to repeat, primary deviation is the deviation seen in palsied eye when the patient is fixating with his normal eye, and secondary deviation is the deviation seen in the normal eye when the patient fixates with his palsied eye. In a paralytic squint, secondary deviation will be more than primary deviation, and this is due to Herring's law of equal innervation. So that is all for this video. Please like and share this video with your friends and colleagues if you found it useful. And please subscribe to my channel to support free education. Thank you very much.